Hello everyone, René here. Welcome to the DayZ Encounter Guide. First of all, this is a hard video to make for everyone. Feel free to leave a comment about everything you disagree with or something that I forgot, so we can have a discussion about it. And maybe I can even create a follow-up video on this. You should also know that I'm the type of person that rarely shoots unless provoked. So that's mostly the point of view I create this video from. From the perspective of a survivor, there are basically four things that can happen. You get shot at and have to fight or flight. You spot someone yourself and get to decide to fight, follow, talk or leave alone. Someone starts talking to you. Or you spot each other at the same time. Let's start with the fact that you get shot at and you don't drop that immediately. The first thing you can do is turn around and shoot back to try and suppress them. This works best if you actually know where the enemy is. If you immediately manage to land a shot on your attacker, he might back off. This is a very risky move, and having a good aim is very important in this one. If you are with a friend, you should let them suppress the general area where you are getting shot from. The second thing you can do is try to get in cover. If you are carrying anything in your hands, like a base building item or whatever, drop them immediately and run into the darkness. Into cover is always preferable. If you are using a head torch, you can put the battery on the hotbar and turn it off on demand. If you are overburdened, you can teach yourself to drop your backpack immediately when in danger. If you are hurt and too far away from cover, shooting back might be the only option. If your attacker is close, you can also try and surrender. After any encounter, you should always evaluate what you could have done or what you should have done differently. If you were in the open, could you have prevented that? Should you have tried to retaliate immediately? Did you run into cover immediately? Were you too far away from cover? Did you scan the area good enough? Or did you stick around for too long? These are all questions you should ask yourself. Here is an encounter where I saw someone first. I decide to talk to him and he still manages to kill me. I encountered many of these kind of situations, and lessons learned from me here are always approach someone who doesn't have a gun in his hands with a gun in your hands. And that gives you control over the situation. If you don't have a gun and he does, try to avoid him if you can. If he has his gun out, follow him and wait until he's in the building to be able to talk to him safely. If someone aims a gun at you, no excuse, shoot. Clues to tell you that they are with someone else is that if they are quiet for a little time, so they can inform their possible friends on Discord or TeamSpeak. If you have approached them and they start stalling for some reason, that's a good way of telling they are possibly with someone else and their friends trying to rush in to get a shot on you. If people talk in a sarcastic voice, like they are not taking the game serious enough or fake roleplaying, that really makes me distrust them. As this game is a sandbox game, it is appealing for many different type of players. It's not always clear, but you can try to categorize them. Example categories are murderers. They are just there to shoot anyone and everyone. They are not interested in talking. Hermits. They are just there to roam the lands. They are not interested in fighting. Survivor. They can lean towards both murderers and hermits, but it often depends on their mood. Trolls. They want interaction, but they are just there to mess with people. They are not to be trusted at all costs. Based on the clothing they wear and based on their movement, you can often identify them. There are also better and worse times to approach someone. If someone is looting around, he's probably looking for stuff to upgrade or for food. And it's safer to approach that guy than if someone is running through a town with a weapon in their hands in a complete military outfit. They are probably just out for blood. People definitely are more on edge on military areas than in a random small town on the side of the coast. If there are groups involved, it makes things a lot more complicated. The most valuable thing I can tell you about that is that you need to try and make sure that everyone of the group you want to approach is known to you. Try to contact the one guy that is furthest away from the group so you can still bail if you need to. Or try to approach them when they are all standing together. But a safer choice is obviously to not approach them at all. If you are suddenly talked to, you should always try to find the time to assess the situation. Is there one guy that is talking to you? Are there more? Does he have friends? Try to keep talking to them. Tell them your name and tell them what you're looking for. You need them to like you and to trust you. Some people will hold you up with a gun pointed at you. If you then try to run away or take your gun out, you'll just get shot. But sometimes people are sloppy in their holdups. They will try to hold you up when you're just at the corner of a building or they are not pointing their gun at you, etc. Assess each situation differently. Some people will also tell you to put your hands up so they can just kill you easily. So putting your hands up isn't always a guarantee of survival. If you spot each other at the same time, there are several things that can happen. The friendly approach is of course to wave. This is usually what happens if you see each other from a larger distance. Often people try to commit to both putting your weapons away to generate more trust in the situation. If they aim at me at any time, it usually loses my trust immediately. I've had it happen quite a few times that I said hi, someone aimed at me in a reflex, and I started to raise my weapon. They lower their weapon again while I'll shoot them, as I have no time to retract my bullets. So if you are one of these reflex people, try to work on that, because it will get you killed. Questions I always ask people in every scenario are: are you alone? What is your name? Did you see anyone else? Where are you going? Where have you been? This way you can get all the information you need, but it's also a way of seeing if they are trustworthy or not. If you are looking for anything specific like a car or a camp, just ask them, as you can learn a lot about the areas where you haven't been yet. Betrayals are hard to work out, as you already crossed that initial meetup. Usually when a betrayal has happened, you're too late to react properly, but often if you reflect on the situation afterwards, you can probably point out several red flags. Watch out for people giving you food or letting you look in their backpack or another container. They want you to be in your inventory when they shoot you in the face or try and tie you up. Watch out if people are trying to get behind you. Don't stand still or drink at a well if you do not trust the guy you're with yet. In the end, there are endless amount of scenarios that you will have to deal with at some point. Follow your intuition. And if you do not trust the situation, the best way to survive is to just run away. Assess each situation and learn from your mistakes. In the end, it's you who decides how to deal with different scenarios. I hope this video helped you out. Please let me know your thoughts in the comments, and I will see you all in the next video. Stay safe out there and keep on surviving. Thank you all for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please vote in the poll what you want to see in the next guide video, and I will see you all in the next one. Cheers.